the biggest issue for people is that they feel lost. People feel very, they get lost, I guess, between systems. So one of the things that I know, not just in Canada, but really I would suggest in many, many countries, that we struggle with is losing people between systems. So it's those points of transition. It's that time when somebody has been diagnosed with a life-threatening illness and they're given that information. Maybe they have to change care providers at that point. It's that time when maybe they've been palliative for a while, but then they're needing kind of that next level of care, that next treatment or whatever it might be. And those are the points when people tend to call us. And I think they're calling because they want that reassurance, maybe that roadmap of what the future will look like. And one of the best things that I think we can do is listen and respond to people with information that we've learned from other individuals and families who've gone down that road before. It is a complicated transition for people to make. You know, at that point when you've been given this information, it's not like you're given a lot of information. You're given information usually about what you're experiencing at that time, what might come in the weeks ahead, sometimes what might come in the months ahead, but often people are given little snippets of information. And so they don't feel like they have a tremendous amount to go on in terms of how do they plan for their well-being and for the well-being of their family members. One of the things that can be really difficult is what information do you communicate? How do you communicate that? And when do you communicate that information? So a lot of what we are doing, what our counselors are doing with families, is really walking through with them what they know, what they feel they need to know. So kind of identifying some of those gaps for people, and how do they get that information? Sometimes it's helpful for people to know, here are the kinds of questions that other people tend to have. And people quite often want to know, who will be my care providers? What are the options if I find I can't manage at home anymore? What might I explore at that point? How do I tell my children what's been going on? What do I tell my children? You know, how do I begin to even manage all the family and friends and the questions and all of that? So it's, again, it's different for everybody, but that being said, there tends to be kind of that core piece of communication that can be quite difficult.